everyone. We are back with another Tournament Tuesdays. We're going to try it again, because we were going through our first run of recording, and I guess I don't know how to turn on commentary. So, you know, I'm really smart, guys. I'm just letting you know. So, we're going to be doing the 150cc every four races. We're going to be changing up the cart customizations, because I know it's going to happen every once in a while. We're just going to be running through the first four cups of the game, because if we did all the other ones with it, then this video would literally take 3 hours.
Okay.
So, hopefully, the audio does not turn itself off. Because if it does, I'm running out of the house. And I'll be creeped out.
Believe me, there were times when I've thrown my microphone over. The thing just wouldn't work.
Oh yeah, and just went back to listening to the video or watching it, and then just hear the mic just go...
Right, yeah. Well, most of the times when I've thrown my microphone, it's been out of rage, like playing Crash Bandicoot.
I really wish I could play Crash.
Oh, it's fantastic.
It's...
I heard that the new one is a lot harder than the original.
In the sense, well, yeah.
Like the remake.
Yeah, I mean, they did add a level that was originally not in the game for obvious reasons of just being too darn hard.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
It's great.
Yeah. No, the least favorite level is, what's it called? That one bridge level I'm trying to remember.
For what, the Tiger one? Crash 3?
No, Crash 1.
Oh, God.
This is like the second bridge level. That was the one that made me lose it.
I don't know. I wouldn't know because I never played Crash.
Yeah. He's a youngin. He doesn't get...
I'm only from 97.
Well, you're older than me.
I'm older than both of you.
Yay.
I'm 99.
Wait, what? You're 99?
Yes.
There is no way.
No, I'm not believing that either.
I'm an old soul trapped in a young body.
There is...
I'm calling hacks.
There is no way you are 18.
Yeah. No, people think I'm older. Like people...
I thought you were 21.
Yeah, people have thought that I was in my 30s before.
This guy's broken. Sakurai, please. What the hell is this?
Like I was out with my mom one time, and they were like, "Oh, you guys are out on a date," and I was like, "No." Could not stand that.
We need Sakurai. Please nerf. Ban.
Yeah.
There is no way you are 18.
I got into an R-rated movie when I was 14 once.
What the heck?
Yeah.
Well, actually, I'm not really surprised. I went to see my first R-rated movie in... I don't think it was my first. My first R-rated movie in theaters in 2009. It was Zombieland.
I'm trying to remember what
which
my
is
first
fine.
One was. I remember one of my first ones was Hitman, but...
Hitman, like...
That movie that came out, I'm trying to remember what it was called. It was recent. It's like way, like overly violent. It's like some like really brutal. Like it wasn't like the video games at all.
Oh, I don't know why I was thinking of Kingsman.
Oh no, Kingsman was great.
I actually haven't seen either of those.
I would strongly recommend it.
Yes, go watch Kingsman. You'll like it.
Yeah.
I've heard the first one was good, and the second one was just a little worse, or like a little a little less represented than the first one.
I mean, yeah. Then again, you kind of come to expect that with sequels.
Okay.
Could have been worse though.
So, Star Wars: The Last Jedi has a 90% on the tomato meter.
Oh, yeah,
audience score has 49%.
I honestly didn't dislike it that much. I mean, there were, you know.
Why the hell do we have over half of our world population not understand the mind of Rian Johnson?
Yeah, I mean...
Like, it's amazing how much the world has transitioned into the realm of Donald Trump.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of the hate comes from the plot holes, and I understand that.
Honestly, the story was a little bit out of place at times, mm-hmm. and the Star Wars scene swipes were a little confusing or, like, wrongly used.
Yeah, plus there were certain things that were, like, you know, fans heard about it and they were like, oh, why'd they cut that from the movie? Because originally, Luke Skywalker was going to be, like, you know, like, not the grumpy old man. Like, he was going to be like, all right, I'll train you.
Oh, no, that's a fan theory. That's not an expectation. That was a theory.
People got
upset about that Luke turned into the new Ben Kenobi.
No, it was like an interview with Mark Hamill, and he was saying, like, the original script was going to have, like, that end scene. There was going to be, like, boulders floating behind Luke.
Oh, yeah.
And they filmed it that way.
Right. Yes.
Yeah, that was originally how they were going to do it. Then they changed directors and changed direction. But supposedly, nobody knows exactly what it was going to be, but like something happened where, what's her name?
Rey.
Daisy Ridley?
Rey.
Yeah. She was pulled aside and talks to the director and then, like, asked about what her character is going to be like in episode 9, and then it, like, brought her to tears or something like that. But now...
Because,
like,
we don't know.
Yeah. Like, now we're never going to know because JJ's taking back over.
JJ's got to pull something out of his ass for this one.
Yeah.
I mean, he kind of did for The Force Awakens to start it off.
Yeah, but I imagine, like, you know, what happened with Last Jedi probably threw a wrench in those original plans.
Honestly, as much as a lot of people hate The Last Jedi, and for some reason it's explainable, I still think that The Last Jedi is one of the best ones.
Yeah, no, I definitely don't think it's the worst. Some people are out there like, it shouldn't be canon. It's the worst one ever. No.
Oh, yeah,
no,
it should
Phantom
be like...
Phantom Menace is the worst one ever.
They should be removed from canon. No, Attack of the Clones is the worst one ever.
Yeah, I don't like...
Phantom Menace is actually one of the most enjoyable ones, to be honest.
Yeah.
I'm kind of weird when it comes to Star Wars. My list is, like, off the charts.
Yeah, I mean, I guess if you have a Star Wars movie where you have a monologue about sand, I guess that's understandable why you wouldn't like it too much. But I just didn't like how 90% of Phantom Menace was negotiations and politics.
Oh, I was fine with that. If it's part of the story and it moves the story along, I'm...
Right, I don't
care what it's about.
Right, I mean, it was just some of it that was like, you know, we believe such and such is happening. We have evidence because we were survivors of it. And it's like, no. You know, like stuff like that where it's like, okay, clearly this is happening, but people are ignoring it.
Yeah.
But, that and also Jar Jar Binks or anything.
I don't care about Jar Jar Binks. I feel like people are giving, like, way too much smack about him now.
It's not that I hate him, it's just I don't care for him. He's, you know, if you look at him in the future movies, he definitely grew as a character, yeah. He ended up becoming a member of the Senate.
He ends up becoming worse than the Attack of the Clones for giving ultimate power to the Chancellor.
Oh, he was the one that pulled that trigger.
But other than that, just, he's fine. I don't really have any issues with him.
Yeah. I mean, I can't say I necessarily hate him, but that being said, I did like Phantom Menace for certain things, like Darth Maul, Qui-Gon Jinn. I loved those guys.
People honestly think that Rose Tico from The Last Jedi is considered the new Jar Jar Binks.
Really?
Yeah.
No, not at all.
I've read it on the internet. There was like a meme saying like, which one would win in a fight, Jar Jar Binks or Rose Tico? And the caption for the character was the worst under Jar Jar Binks. It said the worst character of the trilogy, and under Rose, it was the worst character of the trilogy. Oh yeah, the holiday special that never happened.
Yeah. What holiday special? No.
I don't know. It came out in like 78 or something.
Yeah, I actually watched it. It's horrible.
It really is.
No, if anything, Porgs are the new Jar Jar Binks. If anything.
Yeah. No. Porgs didn't fight.
Well, right. And that's like, the well, difference. Right. I'm saying, like, there isn't really any new Jar Jar Binks, but if anything would be even remotely comparable to that, then that's what?
No, it would be DJ.
DJ.
DJ from The Last Jedi. He was the, Codebreaker.
Oh!
Yeah, he actually had a name.
The character that actually was disliked. Instead of people overreacting over the film.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't necessarily... Well, okay, I disliked him...
Oh my god, I hated him walking out of the film for the first time. I was like, who the fuck even is this?
Towards the end, I grew to hate him. He was like, maybe you're right. And then it was like, okay, he's gonna come back. He's gonna, like, swoop in some, like, you know,
ship. Oh,
he's gone.
Yeah, right. He's dead.
Right. Just made off with his payment left. And it's like, wow, they actually just let him go and pay him? Okay. That's cool. Yeah.
And the way that he explained his reasoning behind joining the First Order, he was like, we got caught.
We got the
deal.
Right. He, like, went and, like, spilled the beans about the entire, like, jeez.
And what the fuck was that little short monologue that he had with Finn when they were talking about, like, it's all machine part?
It was basically just an allegory for war. Yeah,
that French war is a never-ending cycle.
Yeah, there's no good guys.
It's an allegory for war.
Right.
It's
war never changes.
Gotcha.
And then it was something else. And, it was the whole Princess Leia thing. But I'm not even gonna touch
Leia
that.
In Spain.
Yeah, Dwayne really.
Dwayne here.
No, Dwayne hated The Last Jedi. He's just trying to say that he didn't hate it. But he really did.
He hated it, but didn't, not as much as he...
Not as much as he wants to fake.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it, but I'm not the biggest Star Wars guy.
You know,
I still liked it.
Something that I absolutely hated was that lady that took over for Leia. Oh, I forget her name.
Laura Dern. Her character was...
Holo?
Holdo,
yeah. She, like, didn't let Poe in on that plan at all when she could have just said, like, oh, we're, you know, getting ready for an escape, and it's gonna be...
Yeah, she kind of didn't say anything.
Right. And then he ended up committing mutiny because of it. It's like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
It's could have been avoided, but okay.
Her move to hyperspace into...
Oh, that...
Those ships, though.
I actually liked that.
Oh, nice. Yeah, that one's definitely a highlight of the film.
Oh, what the light speed?
Is your controller doing that?
Probably.
Okay. Let's go back.
Yep.
It's still doing that.
Is it Start XY or something?
Nope. Let's go to... No, not pair. Give us a sec, guys. I think it's just your controller.
Oh, gotta do the Nintendo thing.
Boop. Come on. Okay. Try it now?
There.
Okay.
That's better.
Alright, we got it figured out. But yeah, Last Jedi, I don't really think it was a bad movie.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think it was a bad movie either. It wasn't the best Star Wars, but it wasn't the worst at all.
Honestly, if we weren't planning on recording today, then I would have went to the movies to just see Star Wars again.
Oh, it's still in theaters?
Yep.
Oh, wow.
It's only been like a month.
Really? Wow. Oh, wow, it has.
It was released on December 15th.
Yeah. I still gotta see Jumanji.
I'm not seeing Jumanji. Because I hated the first one. And I remember hating the first one so much that it was just... I walked away from the movie saying, what the hell... What the hell was even... Was that? Yeah, the Robin Williams version. And the second one just looked worse. Because the story just wants to extend throughout its
sequel. Yeah, it's a dumb concept, but... I heard that, Jack Black plays a teenage girl very well.
Yeah.
That's mainly what I'm gonna go see it for.
That I really don't care about, because Jack Black really can play anyone.
Yeah. I heard that he's absolutely horrible to work with, though.
I've heard that about some of his co-stars in the Kung Fu Panda movies.
Yeah, I wouldn't doubt that.
Because it was all voiceover and they had to do it in the recording room and everything.
Yeah.
But,
I mean, I've met some nice voice actors, though.
Yeah, most voice actors are actually pretty nice.
Yeah. I mean, you know, that being said, I can't really say anything about all voice actors. I've only met a few.
I really just think our animated movies recently are going to be bad.
Because
Ferdinand was a start of it.
Yeah.
And there was that movie that was like The Star or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
That started Donkey with the Walking Dead star.
Yeah.
And then there's going to be, like, a Yeti movie coming out that's, I think, is going to be bad.
Yeah. I mean, I heard, Spider-Man movie. The Spider-Man animated movie doesn't look like it would be too bad.
That one actually looks pretty good.
Yeah. That and,
not sure.
What was it? Something Heroes? I don't know. It's not... I forget what it was.
Pokemon Heroes?
No, it was like some... Like, I think it might have been a Build-A-Quill Tale or something like that.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, but either way, that one doesn't look too bad either.
Was it the Stone Age? Or no. Nothing. Or, well, yeah, the Stone Age movie. Mm. The movie that was created...
Early Man?
Early Man, yeah.
No, it wasn't that.
yeah, that one doesn't look good either.
Yeah. No, at least there would be more stop-motion films like Kubo. I actually really enjoyed that one.
I never saw Kubo.
Really? It's a really good movie. Yeah, it's sad. It's not for kids, in my opinion, but...
Was it made by the same creators of Coraline?
I think so.
I'm out.
Yeah. Well...
Because I hate their animators. Their movies are... creepy, and they're only made for horror movies.
Yeah. I mean, this one isn't exactly, you don't really get the horror vibe from it. If anything, you get, like, a folk tale type
vibe.
Oh,
no. I get, like, completely traumatized.
Well, right. I mean...
Especially Coraline and Nightmare Before Christmas.
Right. I mean, Kubo specifically. The other ones, yeah, sure. No, definitely. Those are creepy. I hated Coraline when I was little.
Yeah, I hate Coraline, and I think the Nightmare Before Christmas is okay. I don't think it's an amazing movie, but I just think that it's overrated, personally.
But, I mean, Kubo is a different tone entirely than any other one of his films that I've seen.
Gotcha.
And Fantastic Mr. Fox was really good.
Oh, yeah, that was great.
Yeah.
Which one? What was Fantastic Mr. Fox?
Fox. It was like... this,
Fox McCloud.
Yeah. Guy looks like him, but it was like... This fox, pretty much having to defend his home because some guy wants to go and dig up his tree and kill his family. That's it in a nutshell, but I'm not really good at summarizing things sometimes, but...
Gotcha.
It's a pretty good one, and plus, instead of cussing, they just say the word cuss.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah. So, like Custom.
Actually, no, funny is not the right word I should be using. Clever is the better one.
Yeah. I don't know. I think the main reason I want more stop motion movies is just because of Wallace and Gromit.
Oh.
Fun fact?
Mm-hmm.
Never saw Wallace and Gromit.
Strongly recommend it.
Yeah.
Plus, Curse the Were-Rabbit is great. It's
God, that one scared me when I was little.
I did see Chicken Run.
Oh, yeah, that was, it's by the same people.
That was a nice movie.
Yeah.
Except the only difference is I watched it in German class, so they had to put the German voice actors in there.
Yeah.
So it actually wasn't really that good at heart.
I mean, it's probably more accurate. I think the movie takes place in Germany.
Doesn't yeah, it? It's like sometime during one of the World Wars, think World War II.
I think it was World War II.
But, no, I mean, I have that movie on DVD, the disc is all scratched, so it's, like, not really able to be watched, but, no, it's a pretty good one.
And come through with the second place.
Alright.
Come through with the win.
There was a movie that I watched, there was an animated movie that I watched not a couple years ago, it was actually, like, almost 10, it was made by the same creators of The Polar Express. I'm trying to remember what the name of it was.
That was a good movie.
You know Polar Express takes place in Michigan?
Seriously?
Yeah, it takes place in Grand Rapids. The guy who wrote it, he's actually from here. He's Jeez. From Grand Rapids.
Well, it shows you can get somewhere in Michigan.
Well, I know where to find him and say thank you for an amazing movie. Right. But, no, the movie I'm talking about is, fuck, what's the name of it? It was like Tintin or something.
Oh,
Tintin's
God,
great.
That one was great.
That's a great movie.
I remember seeing that in theaters with my dad before, and we watched a movie loving it.
Yeah.
Hoping for a sequel, actually.
No,
yeah.
And the guy who wrote it was the showrunner.
It was rumored that there was going to be a sequel, but it never came.
Yeah, I did hear that it was supposed to. Oh, okay. I heard that it was supposed to be a sequel, but. I heard that they canceled it.
Yeah, meanwhile, we're getting things like Paddington instead.
Paddington's actually really good.
I liked the first one, but I don't think that the sequel's gonna
I have
be
good. Sequel's actually really good.
I've never heard of Paddington until I saw a preview for the
Paddington's
second one.
Paddington's a British he's a British children icon.
Then,
I did see, like, some of Paddington 2, and I did know that. I do know that the bear is British.
Yeah.
Yeah,
no,
Paddington 2 is really good. Both of those are pretty good.
And an animated movie that, unpopular opinion, actually, animated movie that I really enjoyed was Hoodwinked.
Hoodwinked was okay.
I've actually never heard of it.
It's like Red Riding Hood meets, like, some sort of cop interrogation movie.
Ah.
No, one was a really underrated one.
What?
Cats Don't Dance.
Oh. I think Romeo and Juliet's pretty underrated.
Which Romeo and Juliet?
Romeo and Juliet.
Oh.
They're gnomes.
Which reminds me, I went to the movie theater and saw a billboard for a sequel.
Yep.
I'm dreading it.
Sherlock Gnomes.
Oh. That's the type of movie that you can't make a sequel to.
Yeah. You really can't.
Like, age 70 years there in earlier sentence. You alright?
I kind of ran into a hammer.
At least you didn't get smashed by one. We remember that day.
I remember that day. It was today.
Oh, no, you weren't there. It was with me, Brady, Nick, and Josh, and we were all on this course. It was at, like, the very end. When Nick came across the hammer, he got smashed.
Was he in first or something?
No, he was in, like, last.
Oh.
But.
And I constantly got smashed.
Oh, no, you only got smashed once. But it was funny nonetheless. Nick ended up using my lightsaber to kill himself after that. Used that specific one in that specific spot, too.
Oh, boy.
I actually remember the setup that we had. There was actually a Facebook live stream. My TV was in that corner, and we were all kind of circling around it. I think my bed was there, too. I don't know. I wish I could find the video, but it was funny.
Funny thing, you ever go back and look at your old videos and cringe?
Yes.
Yeah, same here.
I especially do that with my high school shows.
Oh.
Because I'll watch Guys and Dolls every once in a while, and I played as Nathan Detroit.
Yeah.
And, man.
Yeah, no, I did the same thing with one of my high school shows, too. I was in The Crucible. I had to play Putnam, so it was just this overly aggressive, you know, angry, nasty guy, someone that I'm not, and, like, just watching that, I'm just like,
Man, I really wish I could do Crucible. That seems like a show where you should be
just
privileged.
Yeah, no, it was a fun show. It was definitely a fun show, and I know I played the character well, because people told me, but...
Oh,
like, at the same time, it's just,
mostly draining.
Well, yeah, and seeing myself be this person that's a polar opposite of me, it's like,
I got to play a murderer and a rapist.
Oh, wow.
And pretty much, I couldn't get away with the crime. Another person dies because of me, so I get away, trying to get away with it. It's my favorite musical of all time, too, so.
Parade. I used to play The Murdered once.
Yeah.
It was actually very recently. It was last year we did Sister Act.
Oh, yeah, he got shot in the head.
Yeah, I got to play a dead guy.
Nice.
14 times.
I got to play a drag queen.
Yeah, look at you and your big boobs.
I was able to get hung off stage one time.
I remember being dragged off stage. It was actually during Guys and Dolls, too. There was a scene where Nathan Detroit looks outside the Mission Band and notices that Sarah Brown isn't there.
Oh.
And they had to make me faint on stage and have the guy who played Benny South Street. I don't talk to him anymore because he just is an ass. He had to drag me off stage pulling my arm. He had his arms under my armpits. It was the funniest.
Yeah, it seems like that was really funny. I went to go back to my old high school to check out one of their high school shows, and they did, I was so upset.
What did
they do? They did Shakespeare meets Star Wars. No, it was actually executed very well. But, like, I was just so upset because it was like, I could have done that.
Wait, they made the show?
Yeah, it was like King Arthur meets A New Hope. And
what?
Yeah, no, it sounds ridiculous. It sounds ridiculous like Kingdom Hearts, but, like, no, it was executed very well.
Actually, speaking of Kingdom Hearts, apparently there's a Kingdom Hearts orchestra that's coming to my job.
Oh, nice.
In July.
Nice.
By the way, I saw
the box. I heard a rumor that Kingdom Hearts 3 might be released in between July or to September.
I don't know.
But, it was pretty well executed. Like, they had all the characters from episode 4. You know, they had, what's his face? Grand Moff Tarkin. They had Obi-Wan Kenobi, Luke Skywalker. They had everyone, right?
Did they have him speak Shakespearean?
Ooh, some of it, yeah. It was like the characters from the Shakespearean play pretending to be Star Wars characters. Like, it was like King Arthur was, like, just completely delusional and thought that he was Luke Skywalker, and, like, the villain thought that he was Darth Vader. It was funny stuff like that.
That's really weird.
Yeah. And then they did a blunder where they had, like, this giant inflatable balloon to represent the Shakespearean version of the Death Star laser, essentially. It was supposed to be, like, a giant bomb. And wow. One of my friends, he played Luke. And he goes up to it, and I didn't know that this wasn't supposed to happen, but, like, he goes to strike it, and the thing didn't pop on the first strike, and it was supposed to pop. So he just sits there just striking it over and over and over again for, like, 2 minutes. He resorts to, like, gently rubbing it, hoping that that will make it pop, and then it pops, and he's like, oh!
That's funny. Yeah. What did they use for lightsabers?
Swords. Colored swords.
Did they actually use, like, the actual Force Effects lightsabers, or did they just use sticks?
Yeah, it was just colored swords.
Well, yeah, like, it's high school. They can't really use anything.
Yeah. I was going to say, like, you know, I could have given you guys lightsabers.
Yeah, I'm here. As long as you don't break them, if you do, I want $200 from every person.
Right.
Or the person that breaks them, that is. Right. Not every person.
Right. No,
that would be rude.
Right. Like, no, you break mine, you owe me $500. That's Saberforge stuff right there.
I really want to get a Saberforge saber. They're, like, the only company that I know of that's got a good brand of combat lightsabers. Because the ones that I have are just made for display.
Is it the Ultimate Force Effects?
No, the one that I have is from the Black Series.
Oh, yeah. So, I mean, A cheaper alternative, something that I'm probably going to be doing soon, is Ultra Sabers. They have, like, stunt lightsabers for $70.
That's what I may be getting.
Yeah. So they've got, like, a grab bag type thing.
Yeah, but the thing is, with their lightsabers, they always have, like, the same, like, turn-on button. And they have, like, they don't have, like, any style to anything, except for, like, a certain selection of lightsabers.
And this is why I prefer Saber Forge, because this one guy, I don't know how he managed to get them to do it. I'm still trying to figure it out. He got their Saber Forge's Qui-Gon lightsaber. And made the little red, knob on it be the activation button.
Oh, wow.
And, like, I saw that, I was like, I'm so jealous!
Just take the red tip from a glue stick and just super glue it.
I mean, I could do that, but then there are two red knobs on Qui-Gon's lightsaber, and that's not canon. Then they did a limited edition Darth Maul staff, and like I was upset because I didn't have the money for that. But then they were like, "Oh, it's limited edition run. We're just doing it for a little bit."
Wait, Saber Forge had that?
Yeah. It's like a limited.
When?
Edition. It was like last year. Oh. But they didn't really advertise it too well.
Oh well, that's probably why I didn't hear about it. Hear about it if it advertises well.
Yeah, I mean they only talked about it once on their YouTube channel, literally only once.
But yeah, I was planning on getting the Graflex styled lightsaber from The Force Awakens.
Oh.
With the belt clip and the Force Awakens sounds and everything. Actually, I wish they import the Last Jedi lightsaber sounds in there.
They have a thing where you can, it's like, if you build your own lightsaber, like, they can send you the parts and everything, it's pretty simple to put it together.
But, it's like a lot of money, though.
It is, but sometimes you actually save money in comparison to stuff like Champion Tier or stuff.
Yeah.
But, no, they have a thing.
Calculated.
Where, yeah.
Really?
No,
I'm not a threat. Let me get second place, for God's sake.
Or first, if you can. But they actually do have something like that with... they have the same thing with GameCube controllers. Have you ever heard of Controller Chaos? It's a website that consists of... controllers from multiple systems. Like, you could get a customized controller for any PlayStation system, any Xbox system, and they also do it for GameCube games too, or GameCube controllers as well, because they know that Smash Brothers is a very competitive, a very common competitive game, so they decided to customize their GameCube controllers. And there's one where you can customize your own and not just have, like, multiple, or just have like one design. Just look them up. They're actually really cool. Their controllers are over $200 each, but honestly, I may plan on getting one of those eventually and try to customize mine if I can.
That might be a purchase to do at some point. Dang it.
Sorry for the third place.
I'm not talking to you. I'm not talking to you.
Well, he is now, so I guess... Yeah. That was so calculated.
It was.
Ooh, my favorite map.
I totally planned that to happen.
Where the fuck did my phone go?
These are questions. I actually had that moment earlier when I was driving campus, and I I was going back into my car, and I was like, "Oh, where are my keys?" And they were already in the the car, and I was like, oh. Okay,
no, then. Don't you hate it when you lock yourself out of your car?
That's never happened to me, actually.
I actually never had that happen to me either.
However, I do have a...
You are the lone wolf in the situation, yeah. Nick.
However, I do have a hanger in my trunk in case something like that happens. Though now that I think about it, that's kind of not helpful because if I lock myself out of my car, I'm not going to be able to get in my trunk.
I know, I was about to say that, huh? But how would you get in your...
Well, in that case, I have to do a little something called breaking and entering.
That's why they do that.
Bang it really hard.
Yeah, just got to break my trunk real quick.
Oh, there's the red shell. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Why I like Deluxe,
but... Deluxe, we could do Deluxe sometime.
Yeah.
Since it's actually a different game. Because they have different features.
They do. Well, it's only a few different features. A couple new items.
Yeah, you get to hold more items, and you get a third drift boost color.
Yeah.
You get blue, and then orange, and then in... blue and orange in this game, and then in the deluxe version, after orange, there's pink.
Yeah.
Which some people actually didn't know about, which I'm a little surprised.
I kind of picked up on that, and I was pleasantly surprised.
That was not me. I didn't have items, Nick. Shit. Who the fuck was that?
Me?
Fuck you. I dumb. Fuck you, coin. Yeah. But yeah, your father, great man. This track is like so tipsy sometimes.
It is like a Jaquan song sometimes.
And first place. Oh.
I think the most annoying this stage can be is when it's in mirror mode, though. That's when it's really annoying.
Oh, yeah. Mirror mode. Mirror mode Electrodrome is... Well, mirror mode any course is just annoying.
That and 200cc.
Oh, I love 200cc.
I like 200cc, just not on that map.
Oh.
Or on Moo Moo Meadows.
Oh, 200 on Moo Moo Meadows is like the greatest thing ever.
Ugh.
I could literally like fly over the cow section. Like I don't even have to take the minor curves or whatever.
Right.
I can just like fly, just like whoosh, and I'm off. It's the greatest thing.
I have a grudge against Luigi because he keeps the AI for him just has something against me. Keeps knocking me back into second place at the last second, so I'm like, alright, fine, I'll just teach you why you're second fiddle.
I was gonna say, we don't have a Luigi AI with us right now, so yeah. I guess you're okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't have to feel salty.
Just wait until we play Smash.
Played it earlier today.
I wish I played it, but Elise just didn't want to.
I was with my girl playing Overwatch.
Well, look at you. I don't play Overwatch.
I was playing it with Vegeta and Knackle.
What?
They were not going easy on me.
Oh, you have friends named Vegeta?
No, it's the name of the Asian tournaments.
Oh, okay, I was about to say.
Oh, okay. Wait, which tournaments do you go to?
I haven't participated in any, but they go to a bunch of them. Like, they're going to Frostbite.
Oh, yeah. I went up against, his gamer tag is Nom. His actual name is Kyle Warner.
Yeah, didn't we play with him one time?
Yeah, he was at my house one time. Yeah. He's not impossible, but being a Kirby main is kind of
kind of realize, wow, this is like...
This is what actual competitive Smash feels like.
I mean, I will say I've played against harder, but he's definitely up there.
Oh, if you played harder, then you played against either Void or Mr. R.
Yeah. Well, I guess harder from my perspective, that would be Ish, who goes by...
He
goes by Dix in tournaments.
I got to meet Rayquaza.
Nice.
At a tournament out in Livonia. It was like a week or two ago. I think it was... When was it? Because I can't remember anymore. It was on a Monday. I think it was one or 2 weeks ago.
What was the tournament called?
I don't think it really had a name. Nick sent a link to it.
Oh, the Disc Replay tournament?
Yeah.
Oh. How did that go?
Brady and I both won one match, and we both lost to the same Yoshi player.
Oh.
We both lost to a Yoshi.
Yoshi. Was it Yosh God?
No.
Okay.
This is someone different. I can't remember his name, though.
Okay. I only know one Yoshi main.
Ah.
And he just destroyed my soul.
I'm going to be myself in the Kirby outfit.
Huh.
So, in other words, I'm going to play as Kirby.
Oh, boy.
There's my Kirby port.
I'm surprised they didn't do more Nintendo characters from other franchises.
Yeah, I think they only wanted to keep it with just Link and Villager.
Yeah, well, and the Squid Girl.
Oh, yeah, they did. Well, they did that in Deluxe.
Right.
They do have a Squid Boy in that game, too, by the way.
They do, yeah.
It's not just the girl.
Is that Cameron's waifus?
Kirby is only waifu. Actually, no, that's not true. I probably have, like, 1,000 waifus.
Pauline is best waifu.
I have Kirby, I have Rosalina, I have...
Pauline is best waifu.
I have Peach from Melee.
Mayor Pauline.
Oh my god.
Yeah, she definitely has, worked herself out.
Yeah. I was playing that level, I was like, Mario, why did you leave this?
Mario, forget Peach.
Right, like, you could have lived a nice life here in New Donk City. Instead, you have to go save your girlfriend every, like, day from something that goes on a salad.
For something that goes on a salad? So what, turtles go on salads now?
Oh, I just always thought the Goombas looked like shiitake mushrooms.
Oh.
That's what they're based on, but they're based on a Koopa bowl.
Oh, really?
And Bowser in Koopa is actually a Japanese word for a type of food in Korea.
Yeah.
Well, what the fuck? Koopa. Why does Japan have Bowser say it like Koopa then in Smash Brothers?
I don't know. That's a Japanese thing.
Because Japan's just superior in every single way.
What the fuck?
They get video games earlier, they get, I don't know
either. But I wouldn't know, because I don't play Bowser. Bowser's not waifu. Oh shit. I think I almost gimped my own banana.
Oh boy.
Unless somebody else laid a banana down and I just wasn't paying attention.
Bullet Bill in second place. I did not expect this.
Well, that's because there's only three of us.
Yeah. Just very weird for me to see that.
Boom. Wait, are you on Waluigi?
No, I'm Link.
Oh.
This time.
Shut up, Seb.
What?
Shut up.
What am I saying?
You were about to say something.
What are you talking about?
Oh, somebody. Better keep your mouth shut. Know your wife.
Why are you doing as good as Smash Brothers? shut up,
Zach.
He's got the voice like, I'll cut you.
I'll cut the bitch. I'm already gonna have an old prison jumpsuit on later today.
Why are you doing as good as you do in Smash Bros?
I do better in Smash Bros than I do here.
BS.
Because I didn't lose so damn Yoshi.
At least I went to a tournament.
Could have been worse. It could have been Pac-Man. Oh my god. You ever seen those
Palpatine
memes?
Palpatine for president.
Yeah, you ever
please.
Seen those memes of like the
eyes?
I yeah.
The Senate.
Yeah, it's like those eyes things that are like, you know, like crack, meth, weed,
unlimited power.
No, the one of them said the Senate. It was just a shot of Palpatine from when he was talking to Anakin about the whole Darth Plagueis story.
Oh, yeah. I remember it was like a couple episodes. It was the episode where we did a Bomberman, and I went back to it.
Oh god!
there was a moment when we were actually talking about you know, Palpatine's line of "I am the Senate," and Nick did an impression where he was like, "I am the Senate."
I am the Senate. Oh no! This voice. How would you feel if you saw an old man just go, "I am the Senate"? Do like a 180 turn while screeching like that. I would be unprepared for that too. I wouldn't even know what to do.
Yeah, no,
I
just
would laugh.
No, you just pull out whatever holy book is near you.
Do it. But yeah, but,
just crucifying.
Right.
And Seth just loves him. Simon Belmont from Bomberman.
Auto Vampire Hunter. I do my dirty. That's actually what he says in the game.
Wow.
Don't listen to anyone else on what he says.
Wow.
No, pretty much for some reason, Simon Belmont is a character in Super Bomberman Arm, and they just gave him this robotic sounding voice. It's so weird.
So, question. Does that mean that Bloody Tears or Silence of Daylight is
sadly
a game?
No.
Aww.
And Seth did not understand Pyramid Head either.
Pyramid Head is so fucking weird.
Oh,
he's really bad in Bomberman.
Wait,
he has a special move.
Pyramid Head from Silent Hill?
Yes, the
yeah.
Pyramid Head is
oh my
and
god.
Vic Viper from and Vic Viper 2.
Oh my god.
And there's a waifu in there too.
Pyramid Head is a waifu? What?
Not that kind of waifu, but...
Are you talking about Aqua?
Oh, no. Wait, Aqua from Kingdom Hearts?
No,
Aqua
from... Nah.
Because Aqua is bae.
Aqua is bae, I won't even lie about that. I won't even try to lie. I lack the talent to lie about that.
Yeah. Can't even lie.
I'm sorry,
if
but
I
next
ever
is better.
If I ever get into politics and go beyond like some Senate, that's...
you are saying that.
Yeah. They're going to be like, we have a meeting with the rest of the Senate. I am the Senate. Not yet. You know, get up from my desk, grab a screwdriver, and go spiraling at my intern.
Just terrify you? Oh, it's first on their first day. Oh boy, it's my first day. I am the Senate.
Okay.
Stop. Just got let out a re sometimes.
Jedi normies.
What? Why do I keep falling off? I keep laughing.
You're bad.
I'm not. I'm laughing. What is that?
It's a Bowser.
It's a Golem.
It kind of is Golem Bowser.
It is.
It looks like a Pokemon. Why are we catching?
I could, but I'm not near the cut. I'm
you don't
not
have
near
enough badges.
I don't have any badges.
Badges necessary to train it.
Actually, I have a badge from winning the Faerun League.
Ooh.
Fuck at me.
Oh, look at me, I'm also a groomy. I have a badge from the family.
It's called Pokken Tournament?
It's a Pokken Tournament. It's high quality.
Get it.
So, Pika Pika.
No, remember! Pika Pika, motherfucker.
Wait, what was that from?
No, this was when we were all hanging out and me and Dwayne acted really nerdy.
Oh, yeah.
And I just, and that was my trump card.
Pika Pika, motherfucker.
No, you gotta go, Pika Pika, motherfucker.
Just gotta go. And speaking of that, we have to take Kirby? A Pikachu.
I was thinking more Solid Snake Kirby.
I cannot get used to...
Pika,
I cannot get used to that voice at all. I'm probably not gonna get that. I still need to get Mario Party Top 100. That looks like it was really fun.
I'm waiting for Mario Party on the Switch. That way I can get salty.
Another worse Mario Party game?
Yeah.
You're gonna wait for another bad Mario Party game.
Yeah, then I can sit down with my family. We can all yell at each other.
So you have a reason to yell at them?
Yeah.
Why the fuck did you take my 12 stars?
Take my aggression out of my little brother that I've had for the past few years.
There was actually a video on Facebook. It was like a minute long. There was this group of people playing Mario Party
3. I think I know what you're talking about.
I think it was Mario Party 3. It was a group of four people.
Oh, yeah.
The guy that was playing Toad or whatever had like 11 stars.
Oh,
and
my God.
38.
Exactly what you're talking
and 38
about.
Coins or something. I think that was the exact amount. And then there was one of the characters. There was one of the players that went to Chance Time. And he got someone, and then it was Toad, and then someone else. And then the outcome was that they had to swap coins and stars.
Right. Oh, my God.
If that happened, I would have unplugged my controller and walked out of the room.
Yeah, no, that's happened to me. And I'd be like, are you kidding me?
I wouldn't even scream. I would have been like, well, it was nice knowing you all, but I'm going to have to decline my friendship.
Well, see, the thing is, I was in first place, and then, like, you know, something like that happened to me, and I was just getting crapped on for, like, the rest of the game.
Yeah,
like,
I would shut off the system, throw away the game, and then walk out of the house. That's what I would do.
I would just go on a long walk and never come back.
Oh, I wouldn't even go on a walk. I would just take a private jet down to Africa. Or something.
Change my name, change my face, go start running like
something. Yeah, I need a new life. I need to not be noticed anymore by the people who stole my identity.
Go make a living doing palm readings.
They robbed me from my money.
They robbed me of my money, now I'm robbing you of yours with these BS palm readings. Circle of life, my friend.
Stop. What the fuck was that, Nick?
What was that?
What was that snort?
Well, I was getting mad.
That was like those weird minions from Jabba the Hutt's palace.
Jeez, why do we keep having these coughs?
Just that time.
At least this is the last one, so I don't have to worry about it on recording anymore.
Mm.
For about a week.
Mm. See, I'm the kind of person where if I'm recovering from a cold, where I had like some sort of like cough, it's just gonna stick with me for like a month.
Yeah.
I'll be like, are you okay? Do we need to go to the doctor? It's like, I'm probably just coughing at my lungs, but yeah.
No, usually I have a cold and it just stays with me for like a good week, and that's it. You're really good at this game, Nick.
I'm the pinnacle of
Mario Kart gameplay.
Yes, the pinnacle of Mario Kart LP.
He is pretty much Miyamoto himself.
He is so good at this game, guys, I can't even beat him.
Yeah, because you can see I'm right in first place.
Yeah, he's racing still, even after he passed lap 3.
Yeah, I think you forgot to mention it's Thomas.
Is it? Oh, I didn't know that.
Or is it?
I'm sorry. I take back what I said then. Yeah, we just gotta wait 20 more seconds. Thus the 20 seconds. Thus the 20 seconds.
Gonna go like go reverse.
Give it a little bit.
You guys.
You're almost there, man. I'm gonna lap you. I'm gonna lap you. You did good, man.
That'll do.
You did it, man.
That'll do.
Good job. Here's a gold star.
Well, you got you got bronze either way, since there's only 3 of us.
Just for that, you get the gold trophy.
No, we got some kind of medal.
Yeah.
Alright, guys. Well, I guess that's gonna be it. Thank you for listening to our unnecessary commentary until, like, the last cup of the episode. So, we'll see you guys next week on, I don't know what we're playing. So, we will see you guys there. Or at least I will. Do we want to say bye, or should I just...
Bye.
Bye.
I thought we were doing harmonization. I was like, hey, I'll join in. All right, later, guys.